Welcome to Designing with Hall Effect Sensors. In this video, you will learn about some of the challenges in joystick designs and see solutions for joystick implementations. One type of input device used for conveying position information is a joystick. Joystick-like interfaces require user-inputted position information to properly function and are used in various systems including video game controllers, car turn signals, airplane controls, and industrial machines. Joysticks translate position information into electrical signals that are sensed by the electronics in the system. The electronics takes the electrical readings from the joystick and uses it to determine the joystick position. For high precision systems, the accuracy of translation of the sensed reading to the position information is important to detect as many unique joystick positions as possible. Traditionally, potentiometers were used to translate joystick position into an electrical signal that provides position information. However, the contact-based nature of potentiometers has led to issues with wear and tear for potentiometer-based joysticks, thereby reducing their lifetimes. An alternative, more robust joystick implementation can be created by using a magnet that moves along with the joystick and a linear 3D Hall sensor to sense the magnetic flux density from the moving magnet. Since Hall-based joysticks are contactless, they are more reliable than traditional potentiometer-based implementations. Hall-based joystick implementations can detect position by looking at the raw X, Y, and Z components of the magnetic field, or by calculating the resulting angles from the field components. When using the raw axis values, the axis sensitivity error spec of the Hall sensor impacts the joystick accuracy. When using angles, the sensitivity mismatch between the axes impacts accuracy more than individual axis errors. In both approaches, the noise impacts the accuracy and the number of distinct positions that can be sensed. Also, the sample rate of the sensor impacts the responsiveness of the joystick. Texas Instruments has two 3D linear Hall sensors that are well suited for sensing joystick position. These devices are the TMAC 5170, which has a SPI interface, and the TMAC 5273, which has an I2C interface. The TMAC 5170 is best for high precision joystick designs. The device is AEC Q100 qualified and functional safety compliant, allowing it to be used in automotive joystick-like applications. The second device is the TMAC 5273, which is a lower cost device than the TMAC 5170. The small package size and low current consumption of the device allows it to be used in battery-operated, compact joystick designs. In addition, both of these devices have large magnetic range options, allowing the magnet to be placed closer to the sensor for an even more compact design and design that's less affected by stray fields. Here we see the simulation results for a spherical magnet that rotates along the center as the joystick moves, similar to the movement in the animation on the left. In this example, the joystick is rotated along the y-axis. In addition to the magnet's position and orientation, the following information is also needed: the magnet's diameter, the magnet's strength, the air gap between the magnet and the sensor, and the XY displacements of the magnet center to the sensing element within the sensor. The simulation allows tweaking the parameters of the system until the accuracy and size requirements have been met. Now we will see a joystick in action by connecting the joystick attachment to the TMAC 5273 EVM. Due to part-to-part variation and alignment errors, the results may vary from device to device, which is typically dealt with by doing system calibration. In this demo, we first observe the X and Y readings when the joystick is moved to its designated left position. Moving it to the left causes an increase in the X component of the magnetic field. You also see a small change in the Y component here due to the Y position also slightly moving when trying to move the joystick to the left. Next, we move it to the right and notice a decrease in the X component. Then we move the joystick up and see an increase in the Y component of the magnetic field. Finally, we move the joystick down and see a decrease of the Y field. For the next part of the demo, we connect the TMAC 5273 EVM to an MSP432 launch pad that is configured to map the magnetic field threshold values into the corresponding direction keys on the keyboard. Here we see that pushing the joystick to the right causes the highlighted cell to move to the right. moving it to the left causes the cell to move to the left. Moving the joystick up causes the highlighted cell to move up. And finally, moving the joystick down causes the cell to move down. To learn more about our Hall effect sensor solutions for joysticks, please refer to the assembly guide document for the joystick shown in the demo. In addition, the TMAP5273 and TMAP5170 evaluation modules are also available to prototype future joystick designs. Please visit tia.com/halleffect to find more resources and tools.